Hello everyone, welcome to Truth Well Told Tarot. This is the Daily Read and it is for Friday the 17th of January 2020. It is for all signs as usual, so it may or may not resonate with you. You decide what resonates and leave the rest. So, okay. Yeah, we've got the Magician here. It is time to show the world what you're made of. It is time to manifest. What is it in your life that you want to change from base metal into gold? Is it your love life? Is it your money? Is it your home? Is it friendships? Is it career paths? All of this kind of energy, because now is the time when the Magician appears. Now is the time to focus your energies, and he has such powerful energies and says that you do too. The problem is that we're just not really aware of our own power sometimes. Our ability to use our earthly tools, skills, experience, knowledge, and combine with a divine energy to really manifest, create our own magic of transformation. Powerful card. Okay, let's get an energy for the day. What do we have, please, angel spirits guides? Okay. Could be in love. We have caring connections here. You know, this can be friendships. This can be business partnerships as well. So it can link to business as well as love as well. So it is about manifesting something in your life that you want to bring into your life, something that isn't fulfilling you right now. And this is about making that change. Now, manifestation is not easy. I will say it can push you to the edge, manifestation and transformation. But my goodness, is it worth it? So it takes a lot of hard work, dedication, commitment, seeing something through. Angels, what is the message, please? You're ready. You know, some of us can be idealists, you know. This might be where you have to lower your sights or expectations sometimes, I'm feeling for some of you. But nevertheless, you know, compromise doesn't mean any less fulfillment, you know. It is about being a realist. So there's compromise that's needed here in any form of situation. But listen, you're ready. And that's what the Magician says. The time is now. The time is now. Okay, let's look at the cards. This is the Tarot of Dreams card deck. You know how I like the Marchetti decks. This is the Tarot of Dreams. Absolutely beautiful deck. Okay, what do we have, please, angel spirits guides? What is the message? Friday the 17th. Okay, two cards are out. Oh, we've got the Ten of Cups. We have Justice. Get some more cards. Okay, thank you. We've got the Hanged Man. Okay, Knight of Coins. I'm going to get one more for that, actually, the Knight of Coins and Justice, please. Okay, the World. We had the World. Beautiful. Yeah, Ten of Cups, we have the Six of Cups here. And the Hanged Man. What is that? What is the Hanged Man? Yeah. Okay. We've got the Queen of Swords and the Knight of Cups. The Empress is beautiful, bottom of the deck. Okay. Queen of Swords, Knight of Cups. You know, this can be separation in love. I'm definitely feeling for some of you this can be separation in love. Some of you have gone through separation to do with a relationship. And you might have been feeling that you were hanging there for a while. The Hanged Man asks you, in order to release from this energy, he puts himself upside down, generally on the Tree of Knowledge, in order to find answers and enlightenment from the universe from within, in order to really see into his future on the path he must take. This is about looking at things in a different way, in order to release from whatever this was, whatever went on in the past. I feel for some of you, this is very much about allowing yourself to open up to new possibilities now. Don't be tunnel visioned, certainly in terms of new love. You know, we're all very, you know, sometimes it can be that situation, can't we, where, you know, we're very dismissive. We make up our minds instantly. We don't give things a second thought. And you're being asked to compromise on this. And I think this is compromise. I don't like the word compromise. I think you're being asked to give something a second look or review your expectations and the way you are saying something at the moment. Is it realistic in order to bring new love into your life? Is it realistic in order to bring new careers or money or jobs into your life? Is it realistic? Are you opening yourself up to all possibilities now? Because the message is that you're ready for caring connections on all levels. So, what is stopping you? What answer do you need to find from within in order to release from whatever's gone on in the past? This won't have been easy energy to deal with. I'm going to move over here. We have justice. You know, now I do feel it's to do with this Queen of Swords. You know, this is the Libra energy. This is the Libra energy as well. You know, and Libra's wonderful. I mean, it is all about balance, but Libra does stand for justice. This can be where you might be waiting for a just and fair outcome, a decision to be made. Could be an arbitration, could be to do with a legal system or a government institution, whatever this is. Could be to do with money, could be to do with your relationships, because we do have the Knight of Pentacles here as well. It could be division of assets when, if you've gone through a split in a relationship. Justice restores balance, and there's a kind of message here that even though there's been a separation, and you've been really trying to find answers in order to move on, there is an ending here. There is a big ending here, an ending of a cycle. And I do feel for some of you there is change. You're beginning to get back on track. Now, yes, the Knight of Coins can be an offer or an opportunity. I'm not feeling this at the moment. I'm feeling that this is very much about getting back on track. You might be getting back on track in terms of your financial health, having gone through separation of assets, for example. If you have split up from somebody, it is refocusing on your career, how you earn money, how you stand on your own two feet, all of this kind of energy. But this is somebody who is doing the hard work and waiting for the seeds that they have planted to grow into real reward. So there's a message that the hard work won't be in vain. Whatever you've been putting your energy into, it will pay off. I mean, the world is also about worldly success here as well. But I do think there is getting back on track after some kind of ending has happened too. You know, this is, I mean, look at this. We have the Six of Cups and we have the Ten of Cups. This is the Happy Family card. This is the Happy Ever After card. I feel for some of you, that there could be a reconnection to somebody from the past. It doesn't have to be a past love, by the way. It is a general reading. The Six of Cups can be anybody from the past that you knew once. But look, you know, it might well be somebody that you might not consider as a love option. But this is saying that this can be your Rainbow of Blessings card, being fulfilled on every level and happy and joyous. This is the Rainbow of Blessings card for me. This is finding your happy ending. Finding your happy ending. Now, this can also be you standing on your own 2 feet, you finding your own happy equilibrium, and it doesn't have to be a family. This can be you finding your happiness, you know, being fulfilled in your own right. It doesn't necessarily have to be with a family. You know, sometimes, you know, we can take these things literally. It can be a family card, but it doesn't necessarily have to be. It can be the soulmate energy card, the twin flame energy card, whatever you want to call it. Of course it can. But yeah, I just feel that this can also be you finding your happy equilibrium and being happy. Could be with a pet. You know, there could be pets here involved as well. Whatever this is, you're getting balance back in your life at either side of this reading. And it's because you're finding answers from within. You're opening your world from within, looking at things from a different perspective now in order to release, in order to really bring positive change into your life. Because that's what the Knight of Coins is. It's a long time coming. You feel stagnated in that energy. But my goodness, is it worth it when it arrives? So Empress energy is, it is time to embrace the new. This is Venus in Taurus. Now, this can absolutely be new love or be new happiness in some respect. The Venus energy asks you to fulfill the promise of something wonderful here. This is the seed, the giving birth to something new. Generally, in terms of love and finances in particular, that have real potential to grow into something wonderful. But you have to make it happen. Yeah. There could have been children involved in this as well, in this dispute, which might have made it all the more harder as well. I will say that too. But you're embraced, you know, this is an opportunity now for you to embrace the new. The Empress is asking you to go create. She is the co-creator of her life. She's Mother Earth. She has, you know, she is surrounded by paradise on Earth here. And she asks you to do the same. You lack for nothing. Just like her, you lack for nothing. Now is the time to go create, take action, to make the promise of this love or money aspects of the Empress real in your life. Make it real and fulfilled. What do we have, please, Angel Spirits Guides? What is the message? Oh, 2 cards. Okay, yeah, time to flourish. The Lotus Flower Fairy tells you to learn from experience and shed your inner light on any unclear areas of your life or those of others. Yeah. Motivation. When spring approaches, the Flower Fairies urge you to spring into action. If there's something you've been merely thinking about doing, they say get busy and do it. Yeah. Because you're ready. You're ready. Now is the time to really positively transform your life for the better. Allow endings to happen and allow yourself to really embrace the new. Go create something wonderful, because that is what the Empress does. I hope you enjoyed the reading. If you did, please do like, share and subscribe. I hope it's a wonderful day for you, and I will see you next time. Thank you.